Good morning, children. Welcome to today's online Sunday school. We are so happy to be with you once again. So today we'll have a number of activities, but before I say much, I'll ask Reverend to give us his opening remarks. Reverend.
Thank you, Patricia. Good morning, little ones out there. I hope you're all well and that you are keeping safe. You're always in our thoughts and always in our prayers. I surely hope you're going to enjoy today's Sunday school.
Wow. So children, today we'll have Auntie Lillian. It's so nice that we'll have her take us through the entire program for today. She's going to tell us a story on trusting God, trusting the Lord. So let's stay back and enjoy the time with Aunt Lillian. But before Aunt Lillian takes us up, I'll ask Reverend to pray for us. Reverend, will you pray for us, please?
Sure, thank you so much, and Patricia. Little ones, let's put our hands together. Let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you, God, and praise you for this morning. We pray, O Lord, as we have this online Sunday school, we pray that may your Holy Spirit come and dwell with us. May he reach out to all the little ones who are listening to this Sunday school. We pray that help us, O God, especially the little ones, that as they grow in stature, they also may grow in the fear and love of God. We pray of all these things in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and all the little ones out there said, Amen.
And amen. Thank you, Reverend.
Most welcome.
So, children, we've come to that time where we'll have our time with Aunt Lillian. So stay tuned and enjoy your time with Aunt Lillian.
Hello, my friends. It's so good to be back. It's so exciting to be able to worship and fellowship with you once again. I just want to say thank you to Reverend and Mrs. Hawasila for keeping us going during this short break that we have taken. I hope you enjoyed. I know I enjoyed the lessons myself. I trust that you also did. And I trust that you have applied all the lessons that we have been learning. Welcome back. Today's story is entitled, We Trust in the Lord. Joe, who was a foreman of a construction crew, held the blueprints in his hands as he looked over the job. He had to have completed in 1 month. Bob, we are going to have to remove these trees if we are going to widen the road. Yes, boss, I'll have the men start cutting down right away. The men started up their chainsaws and started cutting the trees. But suddenly, Bob turned to his saw and came over to Joe. I know we are supposed to cut these trees down, but I just can't cut that one down, he said, pointing to an old oak tree that had a mother robin sitting on a nest. Why can't you follow simple instruction? Said Joe. I don't know. Maybe you can call me sentimental, but there's a bird's nest in the tree, and that mama bird kind of reminds me of how my own mom cared for our family of seven. I can't be that heartless, said Bob. Okay, we'll think of something. Just cut down the other trees, all right? Yes, boss, we'll cut the oak tree. We'll cut the other trees. So the oak tree with the robin's nest in it was left standing, and workmen continued cutting down the other trees. The next day, the workers came back to find the nest occupied by little wild-mouthed robins. Joe's supervisor came that morning to see how the road was coming. He asked, "Why is that one tree standing?" "It has some baby birds nesting in it. One of my nature-loving workers doesn't want to disturb it. Listen, Joe, we have a deadline to meet. If you don't have this road finished in 1 month, you lose your job. So Joe was in a very precarious situation, either to listen to his boss or to listen to his worker who was trying to save a mother and its little bird. We continue with the story after the song.
Love, love, love one another and be kind. Be kind to each other. Love, love, love one another and be kind. Be kind to each other.
Asking Joe why the oak tree is still standing in the middle of the road. And Joe is torn in between because he understands how delicate the tiny birds are, how they need to be nurtured until they can fly off the nest, and he tries to buy time. He says, "The road will be done on time. Don't worry, son." Joe told his workers, "Leave the tree and we'll come back to it later." Again, they left the tree. When they returned in 3 weeks, they found the nest empty. The family had grown and flown away. But something at the bottom of the nest caught the eye of one of the workmen. "Hey, Bob, look at this," he said. "What is it?" "It's a soiled little white card." "What is it saying?" Bob asked. "Let me clear away the mud and sticks. Look, it is a small Sunday school card. Can you read it?" "Yes, it says, 'We trust in the Lord our God.'" Bob smiled. "Isn't that a good verse for us? Just like the birds had a home in the midst of all that noise and confusion, and they trusted in the Lord to take care of them. Even so, can we trust that the Lord will protect us from the confusion of life? Oh, let us claim the mighty promise. Let us light the torches dim. Nothing is too hard for Jesus. Let us put our trust in Him." I have a few questions for you boys and girls that I would like you to ponder on and discuss with your parents even as we finish today's lesson. Did God take good care of the little Robins? Do you think God led them to a new home? Will God take care of you? What are some examples of times you trusted God and He took care of you? I would like you to really think about those questions. Discuss with mommy and daddy. Discuss with your big sisters and your big brothers. Discuss with friends. This will give you motivation to really take an introspect into your life and think about the times that God has come through for us, that we still need to trust in the Lord, no matter how difficult times are today. Well, I look forward to seeing you another Sunday. And even as we go to a new week, take care of yourselves, be joyful, be kind, and be loving. Bye-bye.
Welcome back, children. Hope you've had a wonderful time with Aunt Lillian. It was so wonderful. We are so grateful to Aunt Lillian for that wonderful story on trust in the Lord. Hope you've learned one or two things from that story over the birds and how they were protected. So, Reverend, any comments on the story for today?
Wow, what a lovely, lovely story. A very good reminder of reminding us and teaching us that we ought to trust in the Lord all the time. Mm. It's very interesting from the story to see how Joe and Bob and the other workers were very much concerned about that one tree that was a home to those robin birds. And on one side, the supervisor really wanted them to have that tree cut and finish the works in time. But at the same time, it was very good that Joe and Bob were very sensitive regarding the home of the little robins. And somehow, God was also concerned about those little robins, because we see that God in his own way was able to protect those little birds. And eventually they found that little card, you know, that little Sunday school card, which talked about trusting in God. What a lovely lesson. And I think all of us, especially the little ones out there, you should always know that when you put your trust in God, He'll surely always be there to protect you and protect everyone that you care about. What a lovely lesson we had.
True. That was so wonderful. Amen and amen to the story.
Amen.
Thank you, Aunt Lillian, once again. So, children, we've come to the end of our program for today. We hope you're going to have a wonderful week. I know most of us are going back to school, and I know that a lot of you are so excited, but we continue to pray that the Lord will be with you all, and we know that He's going to protect you. But what is important is follow all the health guidelines, even when you are at school. You don't have to do things because mom and dad are not here, so they are not watching me. I'll just be, I won't wash my hands, I'll not mask up. Follow all the health guidelines. We know you're going to be safe in God's hands. So, Reverend, before we end, we ask you to pray for the children so that as we begin our week, the Lord shall be with the children and He shall continue to protect them and to bless them. Reverend?
Thank you so much, and Patricia. Little ones, once again, let's put our hands together and pray and thank God for the lovely Sunday school we've had. Let's pray together. Our dear Heavenly Father, we continue, Lord, to thank you, to praise you, and to glorify your name. We thank you, Lord, that you always give us a word of encouragement, a word for the season. And we thank you, Jehovah God, that today you've taught us about putting our trust in you. We pray that God, even as we grow in stature, we pray that, Lord, may you always remind us that in whatever circumstances we find ourselves in, we should always trust in you. We thank you for Aunt Lillian, who has taught us a very lovely lesson in life, but also a lesson that is very important for our Christian walk and even our faith in you. We pray that continue to bless all the little ones out there, that as they grow up, Lord, may they grow up trusting in you. We pray now, even as we've come to the end of this Sunday school, we pray that God, may you be the one to end this Sunday school with us. For we pray all these things in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And all the little ones said, Amen.
And amen. Well, children, we've come to the end of our program. We wish you a wonderful week. May you continue to trust in the Lord. Bye-bye.
Bye.